name is Martin. Welcome to another little Weaselwood furniture episode. Today I can present you already a final project. That's another washing stand or bathroom furniture for a friend of mine. It's kind of standard with some doors and some drawers, nothing special. So I don't want to show you how I built this furniture. I guess it could be boring after time if I always bring the same content. So I skipped the manufacturing of the cabinet itself. But I want to show you how I built the Corian deck plate here on top. I figured out there's not much videos out there who guys show how to work with Corian. And I'm not an expert. I don't know exactly how to work with Corian. It's just my knowledge of tries and errors. But I have to say it works out for me pretty well. And I wanted to give you a nice look around how to work with Corian, and maybe some of you guys can learn something about and lose the fear about working with Corian. It's not that hard, it's just a bit different of a material, but it's very nice to work with. And even if you're not so aware how to work with this kind of stuff, try it out. It's a rather expensive material for just trying, but if you take your time and try out what you want to try out, it's not that bad. So yeah, in this case we have here this countertop or top plate of this washing stand. Looks like a 7 cm thick Corian plate, but it's just a kind of L-shaped cover that lays around an MDF ground plate, which is made out of several layers of MDF plate. And here with this beveled shadow gap between the furniture and the deck plate itself. Now, yeah, that's what it is. Now, let's have a look how I worked with this thing and how I built this deck plate. And if some guys out there knows better like me how to work with Corian, leave me some comments. What would you recommend doing better, doing others? And yeah, we'll see. Now, let's get started. I show you how I built this thing, and then we'll come back and I give you a nice overview of this furniture.
First step is to cut all the MDF parts for the underconstruction of the deck plate. Again, having some fun with big parts in a cramped workshop, but it worked out in the end. Then I started to build the underconstruction. To reduce the weight of the part, I built it as a hollow sandwich part. Anyway, the part weighs a ton in the end. I don't have quite big enough clamps to apply pressure in the middle of the part, so I decided to use some screws. Once they clamp it, and also to reinforce the part further. You won't see the screws anyway, so no problem at all. I built the under construction so that there is a full length plate on top and bottom to give it rigidity, and also used the bottom one to create a nice shadow gap between the deck plate and the furniture itself. Now on to the paint job. For MDF I always use some primer in the first round to get the surface as smooth as possible. Especially on the edges it's necessary to smooth it out. After the primer was dried I gave it a slight intermediate sanding with some 240 paper. To finalize the part, I applied the black spray paint just on the visible surfaces. Let's start with the corian. First I cut the corian to size. For this project I needed one big plate and two strips. To cut corian is not that hard. You can handle it just like wood, but you need a specific saw blade. A normal wood blade would chip all your edges. For this case I use a 300mm flathead trapezoidal head saw blade, which is usually for aluminium. Before I could glue the parts together, I cleaned all surfaces to ensure that no dust would interfere with the adhesive. Then I clamped a piece of 6x8 onto the plate to keep the strip perpendicular while gluing it to the plate. I should have put some masking tape on the 6x8 before I clamped it, but it will keep the glue from sticking to the wood anyway. Now I applied the glue to the joint. That's a special corian glue which is available in different colors that match with the material itself. It comes as a two-component adhesive in special cartridges and cures very quickly, so time is a thing. You need a special dispenser, but the dispenser and the glue itself aren't that pricey in relation to the plates. I pressed the strip against the plate and the 6x8 and clamped it. Finally, I filled the gaps with a bit of glue and let it cure. As the joint was dried, I used my router to remove the majority of the excess glue and then sanded it flush with an 80 paper. Then I sanded the whole thing, first with a 120 and then with a 240 paper to smooth the surface. And the edges, of course. For the final finish, I removed the sanding dust and hit it with a 500 wet paper, which creates a surface like it should be. Before I merged the two parts together, I had to remove the majority of the glue beads on the inside of the joint. And I also beveled the edge of the MDF part to ensure a good contact of the two parts. A well spread amount of glue and a few clamps later, and the deck plate were finished.
So, and here it is, finally assembled and ready to bring it to the customer and mount it. Now, as mentioned, I'm not a professional worker, don't have all that knowledge about working with Corian. One day I started to work with Corian and I wanted to try it out, and it worked out pretty well for me, so this is almost my, third or fourth furniture with Corian, and I like the material, I like to work with it. As mentioned also, it's a rather expensive material to work with, but you can build really cool stuff with it. Now, If somebody's out there who knows better like me to work with it, please leave me some comments. What can I improve and how can I get better working with this stuff? Otherwise, yeah, leave me some comments. How do you like the furniture itself? And yeah, I guess that's all for today. Now, see you on the next project. Have a nice day and work with Corian. It's a nice product.